A moment Julianne Finney has spent years fighting for.
This report is for David. It is for David and the many others like him.
Her son David took his own life in 2019 after a two-decade career with the Royal Australian Navy. She was instrumental in the campaign to establish the Royal Commission into Defence and Veteran Suicide.
It has to be the turning point.
Today, after 3 years, the final report tabled and handed to the Governor-General. At the doorstep of Parliament, the three commissioners with a scathing and blunt assessment.
The problems are clear. They're not new, but they're clear. And we hope that the Royal Commission has achieved one thing, which is to make the problems undeniable.
Issues the Department of Defence and successive governments have known about for years. Between 1985 and 2021, there have been at least 2,007 deaths by suicide among serving and ex-serving ADF personnel, an average of 3 deaths every fortnight. At least 57 inquiries and hundreds of recommendations before this Royal Commission, but little change.
I'd say that's a failure in leadership. What is clear from some of the horrible stories that we've heard is that many people simply turned a blind eye over many years.
Cultural problems within the Defence Force ranging from a lack of support for returning vets transitioning to civilian life, bullying and sexual assault. In many instances, victims who reported sexual violence then let down by the system.
Well, I think we've said publicly that the enemy is often within the Australian Defence Force.
Now intent on ensuring this is the line in the sand. 7 volumes, more than 3,000 pages and 122 recommendations. The key recommendation, establish a new agency to focus on veteran wellbeing, centred on the transition into civilian life, and develop a national funding agreement on veterans' wellbeing.
Just as our veterans and defence personnel step up for our country, we have an obligation to step up for them.
The Commission is also highlighting a misconception around suicide and post-traumatic stress disorder.
Trauma through the cumulative effects of what they experience day in and day out through service and into their post-service life.
The Royal Commission also calls for a permanent body to monitor progress on the recommendations and to report publicly. With a focus now on implementation, the federal government is considering the findings.
And so our government's priority is in ensuring that those who pursue a career in the ADF have a safe and inclusive workplace and are supported from the time they join through transition and service.
And I look forward to doing what we can on this side to work with the Minister to make sure whatever can be done as quickly and as properly as possible.
Senator Jackie Lambie first called for the Royal Commission when she was elected a decade ago.
You're never going to stop veterans from taking their lives. But what you can do, if you're doing it properly, is at least reduce that number.
If we're going to sit down and not take up the recommendations this time, then there is blood on the hands of every politician, of Defence, of the Department of Veteran Affairs.
Hoping to finally turn the page in this chapter. Pablo Viñales, SBS World News.
And if this story has raised any issues, 24-hour support is available for veterans and families through Open Arms on 1800 011 046.